The first thing I discovered about being on a team was I have to serve the song. Serve the team, serve the song, serve my boss. As a drummer, I listen, I learn, I lead, because I'm a drummer, but I ain't the boss. Dude, when I make records, see those? I got 1,300 of those things. When I make record for an 18-year-old kid, which I will do when I go home in a couple days, I've made way more records than them. But I'm a servant. I work for that person. I'm not a big egomaniac. I come in with my cutoff jeans and I'm like, you know, what can I do for you? I try to blow them away and make their music better. In the process, I sound good, but it's about them, man. That's why I work so much. I know my place. In my business, there are egos everywhere. I've been in the same room with Spielberg, Tom Hanks, Elton John, blah, 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 the president. Dude, there's a lot of egos there. I just know my place. I walk into a room, I immediately spot who's the most powerful person, who's in charge, because I got to get along with that person. Do I talk a lot? Do I talk a little? What do I do? What do I need to do to make this work? As a drummer, making a record, I ask drummers, I ask musicians this all the time, what's your purpose? What is the purpose of a drummer making a record to get it successful? The purpose of a drummer is to get the song on the radio to be number one. If you want to be good at something, you got to put in the time, you got to work hard. When you bring me into your organization, I'm going to motivate, I'm going to entertain, I'm going to educate, I'm going to play rock and roll drums with rock and roll music. Everybody's going to leave with something.
I love the shirt, I love the boots. Kenny, always a pleasure. John Fogerty, ladies and gentlemen.
You guys are actually in rock bands, but you don't know it. Anybody who's in a team is in a rock band. Are you the bass player, the guitar player, the drummer, the singer? Who are you? What I learned about being in a band is the band is like a team. It's always greater than the individual. Are you like a drummer or the bass player or the singer, the guitar player in your office? But you see how you can't do it without all the components. It's the team that makes this sound or makes this thing work. I've always looked at it like that.
I was the speaker that was on before him, and I'm glad I wasn't the guy on after him. The life principles, you know, you don't get to his level without the education and the dedication and the hard work. So a lot of people see a drummer and they think, oh, the guy goes and listens to rock music and plays the drums. This is a guy that graduated from college and worked 8 hours a day. And his RPS system, where he talked about repetitive tasks done over and over and over again, that's a life principle that applies to any business. It doesn't matter if you're in sales or human resources or whatever. It's you take a system and you follow it repetitively over time until you master it. And he's truly a master.
But Ringo is doing this. Bravo, Mr. Aronoff. I went, oh my God. So I'd met him, but this was that moment. And everyone's looking at me in the place, and I get down like this, and Ringo goes, oh, it's okay, I'm already married. It's his humor. So I was fumbling for what to say, because I didn't want to say something corny and stupid, but the only thing I could say was the truth, which was, you're the reason why I play drums. You're the reason why I play rock and roll. You set me on my course at 11 years old. It was a drum fill I never could figure out, but the musical director sent me, for some reason he sent me just the drum part separated from the music. I don't know how they did that. And I went, oh, that's what he does. And during the show on TV, like a month later, they're showing it, they're getting to that part, and they show me do the fill, and Ringo is copying it, and he goes, yeah. I motivate my audiences from my experiences playing with people like Sting, Elton John, people like Buddy Guy, Ray Charles, Avril Lavigne, Michelle Branch.
To have him performing right in front of you along with being a motivational speaker is such a unique combination. It was absolutely remarkable.
He's a personable individual. He's a guy who's going to get along with everybody, and he wants to make contact with the audience. He's trying to give his words of wisdom in a way so that it's free-flowing and it's friendly and it's inviting. He's very engaging. I wouldn't hesitate for a minute to have him in any of the other functions that I would ever go to.
I'll tell you a story about being creative. It sounds like a simple idea. Now, everybody is creative. You may not think you are, or some people may not think you are. Everybody's creative. Nobody looks like you. Nobody has your personality. Nobody has your ideas. Not exactly like you. So anything you do that's, you know, you're going to do something that nobody else can do. We're all creative. The tricky thing in my business, like I did on Jack and Diane, once you're creative once, they expect you to be creative again. John Mellencamp used to say, "Hey, listen, I write the songs. You guys got to come up with ideas to make these songs hits. My songs all sound the same." He was right. They did. Acoustic guitar. Then he'd look at me and go, "What kind of beat you got?" After two takes, I'm like, so what I had to learn with him was always think of the obvious and then step out of the box very quickly. Think of the obvious. Don't panic. Go, okay, what's the obvious beat? With John, it was always like, every song. And then I go, okay, that's not going to work. I've done that. I got to come up with something different. Then I come up with something different, and then I try a little even crazier. I'll even do this. Okay, John Mellencamp, straight ahead rock like the Stones. Let's see. What would Rush do? What would Peter Gabriel do? What would Stravinsky do? Just anything crazy and throw it in the mix, and you get one little simple idea. That's how I had to do it. Think of the obvious and think of the unobvious. You know, when I did Hurt So Good, that was the first song. I don't know if you noticed, I played left-handed. In order to dumb my playing down, to learn a different way, a different sound, a different vibe, to not look through the telescope but look through the microscope, I started practicing left-handed because I was a beginner again. I walked in the studio and I start playing left-handed, and John goes, "Man, what's that beat? That's amazing." I'm thinking, oh, this beat that I've been playing for 2 years? He heard a difference. That's what I was saying. You look at the same idea, just do a twist. All you have to do is twist the same idea. Left-handed, so every time I went around and did a drum fill with my right hand, that hi-hat kept going. Just drove the song, and the band followed. We made this record called Uh-Huh. That came after that record that you saw with all the gold records. The record's mixed. It's mastered. It's done. It's coming out. John calls me up. "Kenny, what are you doing?" I says, "Well, I'm practicing." He says, "Dude, I wrote this song. It's amazing." I went, "What are you going to use it for?" It's the record's done. He says, No. We don't have a single yet. And so he's trying to be creative, even when the record's done. So I'm coming over right now. Comes over to my house. A lot of times, I actually am very creative when I'm in a fear situation. I get back, is anybody like that? You know, it's not fun, but it's like, what are you gonna do? It's fight or flight. You gotta, you're saving your ass. So he comes in, he starts playing. I'm like, I gotta come in. He's gonna wait, he's gonna stop, he's gonna yell at me. I go, with my bass drum, and with my fingers, because I don't want to be too loud to make a mistake. And the hi-hat. Some people are no damn good. Became a hit single. I have never played that song. I've never played that beat ever again. Just that song. But it made that song special. It's in the middle of these four songs here. to care immensely about doing great work. And you have to do your homework. And I'm like famous for this. Just ridiculous amounts of work.
Tell you how to do your business. I think your drummer may be a little anemic.